So I had a question from a reader of my blog asking about literature reviews and how to state a gap in the literature. So the question was basically asking, should you explicitly state where there is a gap in the literature, or should you just write about the literature that exists and let the reader work out where the gap is? What I would do is explicitly state where the gap is. So you say, for example, despite the advances in the field, there remains a need to investigate A, B, and C, whatever it is. More generally, there's a rule you can apply to all of your writing, and that is to try and make sure that the reader has to do as little work as possible to understand what it is you're trying to communicate. The reason for this is that when you're writing academically, you have to assume that your audience has very little time and attention to spare. So if you think about publishing a paper and then somebody downloads that paper, the chances are they will have downloaded several others at the same time because they've done some literature search and your result, your paper is one result of many. They then have to read through that little stack of literature. But that is competing with all of the other things that they have to do. So maybe they have a meeting or they have to teach a lecture in 40 minutes time. And your research, your writing, is competing for that person's attention with all of the other papers that they've downloaded and all of the other stuff that they have to do. So if you take the typical academic writing approach and just try and make it as complicated as possible in order to appear intelligent, then you're making it harder for the reader to understand. So if they then read it and say, well, what are you even talking about? What is it that you're doing? And they have to work to figure that out, the chances are they're not going to invest that time. You haven't given them a reason to invest that time because it's written so unclearly. However, if you say, here is an important problem, this is how I'm approaching it, this is what I've discovered, this is why those results are interesting, if you say that as clearly as possible without the reader having to do the work, then it's much more likely that your work is going to be noticed and also cited. If you think about your thesis, where the reader has to read it, they have to read maybe 200 pages. Are they going to be happier if it's easy to read or if they have to work through every single page just to figure out what you're trying to say? So, golden rule for academic writing is to try and make sure the reader has to do as little work as possible in order to understand your point.